Welcome to worship at Southern Hills United Methodist Church. I'm Tom McElroy, and I serve as pastor for the congregation, and I want to welcome Southern Hills members and friends who are joining us today. So glad that you are here with us for worship. Today, we are going to hear the story of Jesus' journey to the cross, the last week of Jesus' earthly life. It's a story that often is called by the church the Passion Story, because it certainly demonstrates and portrays God's amazing love for the world and Christ's sacrifice on behalf of you and me. I think you're going to find good news and hope in it for you and a blessing as you hear the story again. Will you bow your heart with me as we pray together? Oh God, we pray that as we come together, that you'll pour out your Spirit on us gathered here. We ask for the faith that will open our eyes to see Jesus for who he truly is, that we might worship him in spirit and in truth. Oh God, open our eyes to see his glory. Open our ears to hear his wisdom. Open our mouths to offer him praise, and open our hearts to offer him our love. We pray this in the name of our Lord Jesus. Amen.
When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany, near the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it, and will send it back here immediately.'" They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who were following were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of the ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest." Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12.
Let us bow to our hearts together as we dedicate our offerings to God. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, As we bring our gifts and lay them at your altar, we remember the crowds in Jerusalem who laid their cloaks on the road, shouting Hosanna as Jesus passed. They were looking for a Messiah who was different from who you sent Jesus to be. God, search our hearts that we might be confident that the Messiah for whom we long is the one you know we need, Jesus Christ, your anointed one, in whose name we pray. Amen.
It was 2 days before the Passover and the Festival of Unleavened Bread. The chief priests and scribes were looking for a way to arrest Jesus by stealth and kill him. For they said, "Not during the festival, there may be a riot among the people." And while he was at Bethany in the house of Simon the leper, as he sat at the table, a woman came with an alabaster jar of very costly ointment of nard. And she broke open the jar and poured the ointment on his head. But some there, who said to one another in anger, "Why was the ointment wasted in this way? For this ointment could have been sold for more than 300 denarii, and the money given to the poor." And they scolded her. But Jesus said, "Let her alone. Why do you trouble her? She has performed a good service for me. For you always have the poor with you, and you can show kindness to them whenever you wish, but you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body beforehand for its burial. Truly, I tell you, wherever the good news is proclaimed in the world, what she has done will be told in remembrance of her." Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. And when they heard it, they were greatly pleased and promised to give him money. So he began to look for an opportunity to betray him. On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, his disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and make preparations for you to eat the Passover?" So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, furnished and ready. Make preparations for us there." So the disciples sent out and went to the city and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When it was evening, he came with the 12, and when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me." And they began to be distressed and say to him one after another, "Surely not I." He said to them, "It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me. For the Son of Man goes as is written of him. But woe to that one whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one to not have been born." While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, gave it to them and said, "Take, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them. And all of them drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly, I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God."
Behold the Lamb. Lamb who bears our sins away, slain for us. And we remember the promise made that all who come in faith find forgiveness at the cross. And so we share in this bread of life, and we drink of his sacrifice as a sign of our bonds of peace around the table of the King. Of our Savior Jesus Christ, torn for you. Eat and remember the wounds that heal, the death that brings us life, paid the price to make us one. Every stain of sin shed for you. Drink and remember, he drank death's cup that all may enter in to receive the life of God. So we share in this bread of life, and we drink
When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. And Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Even though all become deserters, I will not." Jesus said to him, "Truly, I tell you, this day, this very night, before the cock crows twice,
you will deny me three times. But he said vehemently, even though I must die with you, I will not deny you. And all of them said the same. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, sit here while I pray. He took with him Peter, James, and John, and began to be distressed and agitated. He said to them, I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake. In going a little further, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that, if it were to be possible, the hour might pass from him. He said, Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want. He came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake for 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, and their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them, are you still sleeping and taking rest? Enough! The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand. Immediately, while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, and with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, the one I kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard. So then he came. He went up to him at once and said, Rabbi, and kissed him. Then they laid hands on him and arrested him. But one of those who stood near drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting his ear. Then Jesus said to them, have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I was here with you in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled. All of them deserted him and fled.
To see the King of Heaven fall in anguish to his knees. The light and hope of all the world now overwhelmed with grief. What nameless horrors must he see to cry in the garden, oh, take this cup away from me, yet not my will, but yours, yet not my will, but yours. To know each friend will fall away and heaven's voice be still, for hell to have its vengeful day upon Golgotha's hill. No words describe the Savior's plight to be by God forsaken, till wrath and love are satisfied and every sin is paid, and every sin is paid. What kept him on this road? His love for Adam's cursed race, for every broken soul. No sin too slight to overlook, no crime too great to carry. All mingled poison cup, and yet he drank it all. The Savior drank it all. What kept him on this road? His love for Adam's cursed race, for every broken soul. No sin too slight to overlook, no crime too great to carry. All mingled in this poison cup, and yet he drank it all. Our Savior drank it all.
They took Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes were assembled. Peter had followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest, and he was sitting with the guards, warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none. For many gave false testimony against him, and their testimony did not agree. Some stood up and gave false testimony against him, saying, "We heard him say, 'I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another, not made with hands.'" But even on this point, their testimony did not agree. Then the high priest stood up before them and asked Jesus, "Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against you?" But he was silent and did not answer. Again, the high priest asked him, "Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?" Jesus said, "I am, and you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming with the clouds of heaven." Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, "Why do we still need witnesses? You have heard his blasphemy. What is your decision?" All of them condemning him as deserving death. Some began to spit on him, to blindfold him, and to strike him, saying to him, "Prophesy!" The guards also took him over and beat him. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came by. When she saw Peter warming himself, she stared at him and said, "You also were with Jesus, the man from Nazareth." But he denied it, saying, "I do not know or understand what you are talking about." And he went out into the forecourt. Then the cock crowed. And the servant girl, on seeing him, began again to say to the bystanders, "This man is one of them." But again he denied it. Then after a little while, the bystanders again said to Peter, "Certainly you are one of them, for you are a Galilean." But he began to curse, and he swore an oath, "I do not know this man you are talking about." At the moment, the cock crowed for the second time. Then Peter remembered that Jesus had said to him, "Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times." And he broke down and wept.
As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He answered, "You say so." Then the chief priests accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again, "Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you?" But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with the rebels who had committed murder under the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to this custom. Then he answered them, "Do you want me to release for you the King of the Jews?" For he realized that he was out of jealousy that the chief priest was handed over to him. But the chief priest stirred up the crowd to have them release Barabbas instead of him. Pilate spoke to them again, "Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call the King of the Jews?" They shouted back, "Crucify him." Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him." So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them, and after flogging Jesus, handed him over to be crucified.
Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters, and they called together the whole cohort. They clothed him in a purple cloak, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him, and they began saluting him. "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak, put on his own clothes, and led him out to crucify him. They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry the cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. Then they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide who would take what. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads, saying, "Ha! You who would destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days, save yourself! Come down from the cross!" In the same day, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves, saying, "He saved others. He cannot save himself? Leave the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now, so that we may see and believe." Those who were crucified with him also taunted him. When it was noon, darkness came over the land until 3 in the afternoon. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "Listen, he's calling for Elijah." And someone ran to fill a sponge with sour wine and put it on a stick and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let's see whether Elijah will come down and take him." Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, "Truly, this was the Son of God."
How pale thou art within. Christ suffered. 'Twas all for sinners' gain. Mine was the transgression, but thine the deadly pain.
There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James the Younger, and of Joses and Salome. These used to follow him and provided for him when he was in Galilee. And there were many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem. When the evening had come, and since it was the day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also himself waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God, went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate wondered if he were already dead, and summoning the centurion, he asked him whether he had been dead for some time. When he learned from the centurion that he was dead, he granted the body to Joseph. Then Joseph bought a linen cloth, and taking it on the body, wrapped it in the linen cloth, and laid it in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. He then rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joses, saw where the body was laid.
Jesus, keep me near the cross, where a precious wound on me to all I really.
This is the story of God's amazing love for you and for the world. I think John's gospel summarizes the story best when he said, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that whoever believes in him should not perish, but should have eternal life." That's God's hope for you and our hope for you as well. Will you bow with me as we pray? Holy God, when Jesus breathed his last, you tore away the ancient curtain between heaven and earth, and between life and death, and between us and you. So Lord, as we turn to face the cross, and as we face Jesus in all his suffering and glory, help us to believe and so have eternal life through him. Through Christ our Lord we pray. Amen. Friends, if you'd like to know more about next steps in your life with God or your relationship with Jesus Christ, my email address is on the screen. I'd invite you to email me, and I'd love to talk more with you about that. I hope you will join us next Sunday for worship here at the sanctuary at Southern Hills United Methodist Church at 11 a.m. for a great Easter service, and we would love to have you join us. You can also join us online at 9:30 at shumctulsa.online.church or anytime on our YouTube channel at Southern Hills UMC Tulsa. And now will you receive this benediction? May God, whose arms were spread on the cross to embrace the whole world, help us this week to take up our cross and to follow. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen.